In this video, we're looking at the alpha decay of radon-222, and we're given a little bit of background about radon. Like, where does it come from? It's a daughter nucleus of uranium-238 decay. So there's trace amounts of uranium-238 in rock and soil, and those decays will constantly produce trace amounts of radon-222. Interestingly enough, this actually causes about 21,000 lung cancer deaths per year in the United States. But what we're here for is the nuclear decay. So it emits an alpha particle, and then the daughter nuclei that come after this, they also decay by alpha decay. So if you're inhaling this gas, you end up ingesting a source of alpha radiation, which is very bad because 100% of that alpha radiation is going to be absorbed in your tissues. Alpha radiation doesn't penetrate very far. We're asked to write down the nuclear reaction equation for the alpha decay of radon-222 and compute the energy in MeV that's released in the decay. We have a reference table here. We're given the atomic mass unit written in MeV per C squared. The reason we need that is because the standard tables for these masses, the mass of radon, the mass of polonium, the mass of helium, the standard tables give these masses in terms of atomic mass units. We're going to want to convert those to MeV per C squared at some point in order to get our energy calculation done. So just a real quick overview of what's happening in alpha radiation. That means a helium nucleus flies out of this very large nucleus, and a helium nucleus has two protons and two neutrons. So when my radon alpha decays, I'm going to bounce two spaces to the left on the periodic table because I've lost two protons. This is why I get polonium out of the reaction. Putting things in nuclide notation, I start with radon, 222 nucleons. I can see from the periodic table, 86 protons. This leaves me with 136 neutrons when I do the subtraction. And the result of this decay is that I get a helium nucleus, also called an alpha particle. And helium has two protons, two neutrons, four total nucleons. So there's that guy. And then again, I've lost two protons. So now I'm talking about polonium for my remaining large nucleus. And polonium has 84 protons. That's two less than I had before. I also lost two neutrons, which means there should be 134 of those now. And of course, I lost four total nucleons. So I'm talking about polonium-218. Now there's a subtle point about these masses given in the table. Another unfortunate thing about those tables is they include the mass of the electrons. Fortunately, that's not going to mess up our calculation here, but you should be aware of it. So this is the mass of a radon-222 with all of its 86 electrons. This is the mass of a polonium-218 with all of its 84 electrons, and then the helium with its two electrons. Fortunately, this doesn't cause a problem because the electrons just cancel out of the calculation here. So the idea for finding the total energy released is just compare the mass that we started with, compare the mass that we ended up with. You're going to find that there's some mass missing there, and then we use E equals mc squared to compute the energy equivalent of that mass. So written in math, it looks like that. And this time I'm going to go ahead and compute the missing mass in atomic mass units, and then I'll convert to MeV per C squared at the end. And again, notice in this first term, that includes 86 electrons, but then in these parentheses, that includes two electrons for the helium and 84 for the polonium, so the electron masses just cancel out. And the missing mass here really is a reduction in the mass of the nuclei. So I end up with a reduction in mass of 0.006 atomic mass units. I convert that to MeV per C squared, and I get 5.59 MeV per C squared. Now I think most nuclear physicists would just ignore the C squared and say, okay, 5.59 MeV was released in the reaction. But to be totally complete about this, what we're doing is finding the energy equivalent of that mass that disappeared. And for this, we use E equals MC squared, and our mass was 5.59 MeV per C squared, and we multiply by C squared. And this is why you can just kind of ignore the C squared when you get to this point in the calculation. It is the same number. I get 5.59 MeV released in the reaction. And we're done. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.